I've been Catholic my entire life. I'm from New Mexico, and my family was Catholic. My grandparents were Catholic. Their parents were Catholic, and on down the line until we can see, our family's been Catholic. Part of our Catholic identity was going to Mass every Sunday. And so I don't think there's many Sundays in my life that I've missed Mass. I could probably count on one or two hands how many Masses I've missed. But for me, it was just going to Mass to check the box. I'd go to Mass because I knew there was something calling me. I'm not sure what it was. I moved to Las Vegas and I worked for a nightclub in one of the casinos. And even when I did that, I'd go to Mass on Sundays. So I'd work 9 to 5, but it was 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. And often I'd go out with my friends for a drink after work. And after a couple drinks, I'd look at my watch and say, "Guys, I gotta run." And they went, "Where are you going? We're just having fun." "Well, it's Sunday, I gotta go to Mass." And, you know, they all thought I was kidding, but I was serious. I had to go to Mass. And there was still no connection. There was something calling me. And it may have been my mom. She would literally call me on that Sunday to see if I had been to Mass or not. So I moved to Los Angeles about 8 years ago. And one of the first things that I did was start to look for a church. So I went church shopping. I went to a different church every Sunday. I saw some really beautiful churches and met some nice people. But I still didn't feel any kind of connection. One day I went to St. Monica's church, and there was something different about it. From the very minute I pulled up to the church, I wasn't sure where I was going to park, and I was nervous about getting a ticket because it was street parking, and there was people there kind of directing the cars to where to park. And I thought that was pretty cool. And I get out, and there's people directing me towards the church and welcoming me right from the very get-go. And I get into the church, and they ask new people to stand up. So I kind of stood up, and a guy next to me said, "Oh, you're new. There's a young adult dinner after Mass. You should check it out." And I thought that was pretty cool. And the Mass started, and the music just blew me away. It was so beautiful. It was like professional singers, I thought. And the homily was outstanding. I really felt like the pastor was speaking right to me. And I remember even tearing up at one point in that Mass. Didn't really know how to explain it. But as I was leaving, the pastor was in the back, and he was greeting people as they left. And I told him, "This was my first time in this parish, and I just had a really good experience, so thank you." And he looked right at me and grabbed my hand and said, "Welcome home, brother. Welcome home." And then he directed me to look into the church, and he said, "You're going to meet your wife in that church." And I didn't have a wife at the time, so it sounded like a pretty good deal. So I came back the next week. I actually went to the young adult dinner that night, hoping my wife would be there. But I met some great people there, and some of my friends to this very day. At that dinner, one of the guys that was there invited me to a retreat that was a few months later. And on that retreat, I had a great experience. It was probably the first time in my life that I opened myself up to a relationship with God. And it was a really transformative experience. The next year, I was asked to help lead the retreat. And I remember thinking, "Oh, gosh, what do I know about leading a retreat?" But I did it. Somehow we pulled it off, and it was rewarding because afterwards, a lot of the guys came and said, "Thank you. Thank you. I had this experience that led me into a relationship with Christ." And I thought, wow, something I did helped lead you into a relationship with Christ? That's pretty amazing. The year after that, Monsignor asked me to be a part of the parish council. And I said, "Gosh, Monsignor, you may have the wrong guy here. There's a guy that I went to the retreat with. He's been here 30 years. He's a lector, a Eucharistic minister. That's the guy you should be on your council." I got his number, and Monsignor said, "I don't want his number. I don't want him on the council. I want you. I said, why? You know, I've only been here a couple years. And he said, the parish council's meant to counsel me, to advise me. And I'm trying to attract more people like you, young adults who are searching for a community, searching for a place to worship, and searching for a relationship with Christ. So why would I get that guy when I have an expert on that right here? So I took him up on the offer, and I joined the parish council. And now I get to lead the parish in ways that I never thought that I would. Last year, I was nominated to be the chair of the parish council. So I'm now chair of the parish council. And if you would have told me when I walked into that church that I'd be the chair of the parish council of St. Monica's, one of the great Catholic parishes in this country, I would have laughed at you. But as I look back at my life now, almost everything I have is a direct result of my parish. Some of the very best friends I have right now, I met at that young adult dinner or on retreat. Even my apartment, one of the guys in my small group just kind of overheard I was looking for a place, and he knew of a place that was available, and it's a great place right next to the church. I did meet my wife at St. Monica's. We met there, we got engaged there, and we were married there. And she's pregnant, so we'll have a kid who will be baptized there. And probably more important than all of those things, something I didn't have before that I have now, is a relationship with Christ. And I never thought that was possible. Just like I didn't think I was worthy to be on the parish council, I didn't think I was worthy to have a relationship with Jesus. And that's the biggest thing I've got from it. So I encourage you, as you're planning different things for your parishes, think about somebody like me who's walking into your church for the first time and the experience that they can have from hospitality, music, community, and what kind of impact you can make on their lives.